Hello guys, welcome back to another episode. In this episode, we are going to be designing the authentication pages, that is the register page and the login page. As you can see here on the finished project, the login page is composed of only the navigation bar and the form itself. The same thing with our register page. So let's open our source code in the text editor. We're going to create a new file in the root folder of our application called register.html. And because we need the navigation bar, we're just going to copy everything inside our index.html. We paste it inside our newly created register page. And then we're going to delete everything else except the navigation bar. First of all, let's change the title of the page to register. We scroll down and this header element represents the navigation bar, so we are not going to remove it. Everything else from the page wrapper, we're going to scroll down and select. Select until we meet the closing page wrapper tag, which is right here. We are not going to need the footer also, so we continue selecting past the footer until we meet the closing footer tag, which is here. We remove all of that. Another thing is we are going to remove the carousel plugin because we only used it in the index page. So we remove that also. So this is our page as it is. It has only the navigation bar. Now we can begin designing our register form itself. We are going to enclose our form in a div element with class authContents. So inside this div element, we are going to define our form. And we'll give our form a title of register. And then now we can start defining the individual input elements of the form. Each input in the form is going to be enclosed in div elements, and each of them will have a label, the first one being username. Let's define the input field itself. It's going to be of type text, and we're going to give it a class of text input. We'll give it a name of username, but we are not going to give it any ID. If you remember correctly, we have already defined the CSS for the text input class. So once we have written this, we are not going to write additional CSS styling for the text input field. Having written the markup for the username field, we are going to duplicate this and modify it for the email field. So modify the label, the type, and the name attribute, and we change it to email. Okay, we do a similar thing for the password field. Change it to password. Okay, the next field is the password confirm. Password confirmation. And we're just going to change the name to passwordconf. Okay, now having written the input fields, we're going to add our submit button. And we'll give it a class of btn. And remember, we had defined this CSS class in an earlier video. We'll give another class called btnBig to make the button slightly larger. And again, we have already defined this in our CSS. Now we are going to give our register button a name attribute of register button. And we are going to see the importance of this when we are actually making the website interactive when we are submitting the form. The last thing we need to do on this register form is we are going to provide a button, a link that the user can click on to go to the login page. Okay, and this is all about the markup for the register form. Okay, now we can start writing the styling for this. But before that, let's view how it looks like on our browser. So we'll visit the register.html page on our browser, and this is how it looks. Now we want to make the form less as wide as it is now, and we want to centralize it and give the form a white background. So let's open our CSS file. We scroll to the section where we have written the styling for our footer, and just above it, we are going to create another section for auth pages. And then here we can start writing our styling for the auth pages. We'll first of all grab the div that surrounds our form. We're going to reduce the width, we'll make it 30%. We centralize this element at the center of the page, so we're going to give it a margin at the top of 50 pixels. And then auto to centralize it horizontally. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to give this a padding of 20 pixels, a background color of white. We're going to give a border radius of about 5 pixels. And with that, I think we're done with the basic styling for that element. Let's reload our page and see how it looks. Okay, not bad for a start. Now, a few modifications I want to make here. First of all, I want to centralize this title in the center of the form here. Then, secondly, I want to provide some spacing between each of the input elements. So, we go back to our CSS. And remember, on the form, we have wrapped each of the input elements inside a div tag. So, we are going to select that div tag. And we provide a margin at the bottom of about 10 pixels to separate each of the input elements from the other. And the next thing we need to do is we need to select the form title. Select the form title and align it to the center. We save this and back to our browser. We refresh. And this looks okay. Okay, there are two last things I want us to do on this form. First of all, I want to increase the font size on this button and I want to change the font family. Secondly, I want to centralize this link and make it look like an actual link where someone can know that they can click on. So let's start with the paragraph. It is inside the form, so I'm just going to select this. Select the paragraph element inside the form and align it to the center. Secondly, I want to select the link element inside that paragraph and give it a text decoration of underline so that the user can know that they can click on it. If we go back to our browser and refresh, you will see now that it looks like a link. Okay, now let's move on to the button. Remember, we are given a class of BTN on our button, so let's scroll up to where we have defined the BTN class. Now, we want to add the font size a bit. So, I'm just going to give it a font size of 1.08 em and a font family of Laura. And remember, this is a Google font we added in an earlier video. Back to our browser, we refresh, and this looks good enough for our register form. So now we can move on to the login form. The login form is going to look very similar to the register page. The only difference is that we are going to need only the username and the password field. So what we are going to do is we are going to copy everything inside our register.html page. We create a new page in the root folder of our application called login.html for the login page. We paste the contents of the register page inside here, and then we modify it. We are going to change the title of this page to login. And on the form, this is now a login page, so it will be submitting to the login.html file. We change the title of the form to login, and we need only the username and the password field. So we are going to remove the email field and the password confirmation field. Okay, as for the button, this is now a login button, and we'll give the user the option to navigate back to the register page. Okay, so we save this, we go back to our browser and we refresh. Sorry, we go to the login page, and the login page looks good enough. Now, one last thing I want us to do on these pages is to design validation messages. For example, if the user submits the register form without filling in the username, a validation error is going to be displayed telling the user that the username is required. So how do we design the display of that message? We'll go back to our register page, and just below the title of the page, we are going to define an element and give it a class of MSG, which stands for message. And inside that element, we are going to write the error in a list element, and it will read username required. Okay, now we are going to define three classes for these messages. The first one is MSG for message, the second one is success, and the last one is error. Now, the message class is just going to place dimensions on this element, while the success class will provide a greenish coloring to this element to indicate that it's success. And then the error class is going to provide a reddish kind of coloring to this element so that we know that it's an error message. So let's start with the message class. We go back to our style.css file, and we are just going to define this at the top, just above the navbar, since this is also a general styling. So the first thing is, we're going to make it span the entire width of the form, so we'll give it a font size of a width of 100%. We'll give it a margin at the top and bottom of 5 pixels. We'll give it a padding of about 8 pixels, and we'll make it have round borders. 5 pixels. So that is it for the message class. If you refresh it, it won't look very well. It won't look very good. Let's remove this list styling. We're just going to say list star none. Okay, this looks good enough now. Now let's start designing the coloring for this element. We are going to start with the success. So let's define that class just below the message class. We are going to give it a color. The text is going to have a color, a somewhat greenish color. The border is going to be of the same color. And lastly, we are going to give it a background color of light green. Okay, we save this and we go back to our form and refresh. And this is how our success messages are going to be displayed. Now, the next thing we are going to work on is the error message. Okay, so we go back to our CSS and we define a CSS rule for the error. It's going to have the same properties as the success, so let's just copy this down here, and we are just going to modify the colors. So the text color is going to be somewhat dark red, and so also will be the border. And lastly, we'll provide a light red background color. So we save this, we go back to our browser and we refresh. And this is how our error messages and validation messages are going to look. So I'm just going to comment this out. We are only designing this for the sake of the future when we are making it interactive. When we are making it interactive, only then will we display a username, a validation error message if the user made an error filling the form. So with this, we can say we have come to the end of this tutorial. So we are very close to the end of the design for the public section actually. The only design that is left now is the admin panel. And before we get to that, we are going to work on the responsiveness of this public section. And for the responsiveness, we are going to work on the responsiveness in the coming video, the next video. So thank you guys for watching. If you found it helpful, if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, share, subscribe, and comment, and hopefully I will see you in the next section.